Minister, usually when we talk about insurance in this chamber, it's about the cost of insurance and escalating cost of insurance. And in the questions to the Taoiseach in the last session in this House this evening, I, you know, raised a question where the cost of injury claims are coming down and the cost of insurance should correspondingly come down, and we had a discussion on that. But this is a situation where sectors are unable to get any insurance cover. And we've seen this creeping into the activity sector, the sporting activity sector, in the last couple of months, where, you know, water sports activities, you know, activity parks, which water parks, have failed to get insurance. One in my own county in Drumminier had to close because of a lack of insurance. We're now told that ice rings, you know, for the winter period won't get insurance. And we see an increasing number of sporting activities failing to get insurance cover, irrespective of the cost. And now we see this stretching into the equestrian area. In the last weekend, two Pint of Pines had to be cancelled because of lack of insurance. The equestrian sector, the hunting sector, we have 100 packs in this country, and we had only one insurance provider, and they have now withdrawn from the area. So, as you know, the insurance for hunting packs comes to an end for different packs will be at different stages. Those hunts will not be able to have any activity, and consequently, Pint of Pines, which operate under our umbrella, will not be able to operate either. And you know, aside from the recreational aspect of these sports, this is a hugely important business. It's the cornerstone of our national hunt industry, and hugely important both financially and to rural Ireland. I suppose, you know, we've had the disruption with COVID, which put, you know, the national hunt breeding under extreme pressure, and we had Pint of Pines racing cancelled for a number of months. And thankfully, you know, we got that racing resumed. But a second winter of disruption to our activities would be hugely economically damaging. It's the shop window where, you know, our young horses are shown and able to be sold, you know, whether it is to buyers here at home or to the UK or further afield. And, you know, that would impact on the sales of younger horses all through the year. So, look, it's imperative that the government comes up with a solution to this crisis. And a crisis it is. You know, as I said, we've often been in this chamber arguing about the cost of insurance. But this is a completely different aspect, where, you know, various sectors of sporting activity are unable to activate insurance at any price. There was a very substantial claim awarded on the hunting fields in the last couple of months, and that is the reason we put forward for the insurer leaving the field. And that claim, that accident actually happened in my own county. And, you know, the rider was very severely injured. And a substantial payout was received, and you know, a man with a young family, and he was going to have a lot of costs the rest of his life. But you know, we cannot have a situation where vital sectors, whether it is a business with water activities or any recreational activity, which you know involves activity, is going to be left without insurance cover. And as I said, you know, the equestrian industry is hugely important to all parts of the country. And we have to come up to a solution for this, Minister. And we just can't have insurance company cherry-picking what they insure. And, you know, I'm not saying insurance at any cost, because obviously no business can afford that. But surely we can have a regulator that would, you know, would say that, you know, have a reasonable cost in relation to the claims that have been paid out over a number of years, and that insurance companies, you know, to allow it to be operating in this country, would be forced to give a quote at a reasonable cost to all sectors.
Minister, to reply. At the outset.